It's a world first, and it's already really cool to talk, have a world first where you know that even though perhaps it was a small study and gosh, it was hard work, that you know it really has really important results. And so that means that there will be a stepping stone paper that really, as I said, it really helped us to achieve the NHMRC funding, which is about $1.2 million that we received there to do that steps care evaluation in older adults. And these things together then will lead to much bigger, funding opportunities, which mean that we can really make an impact on how these services deliver treatment. It's these smaller trials that really build to much bigger trials that then have the lasting impact.
On a personal note, I think it's really helped me to, and the research team, I guess, which is international, to really work together and build our relationships and our connections and our understanding in ways that I think are really going to seed a lot of research for the future. So aside from getting the actual outcomes from the study and going out and publishing it and spreading the word, I think it's really done a lot as well to help build the skills of the team, and especially myself as a sort of more earlier career researcher. So you sort of have that specific impact of the trial and its results, but then you have that broader impact, I think, and helping to kind of build people up to hopefully do some exciting things in the future.
Oh, look, there's a famous figure. I wouldn't be able to pull it up now and share it with you, but there's a famous figure that was presented about 20 years ago in a journal that focuses on economics of health. And it was an amazing graph, and it showed how much you save in the mental health system for every dollar of research spent. And it was phenomenal. And mental health was, the biggest bang for your buck. For every dollar spent on improving services through research, there was a massive improvement in services and the costs of services in the community. So, I'm a big believer in this. And if you even go back to when I started years ago in Queensland, if you had a child with these problems and you brought them into a mental health clinic, you would be likely to receive a kind of play therapy where you would drop your child off, you would go off and get a coffee or do whatever you were going to do, and then the therapist would kind of play with the child and then deliver them back to you an hour later. Did it work? No. it had no effect on autism or behavioral problems or anything like that. And that was back in the 1970s and 80s. And you look at how far we've come now in terms of the development of evidence-based programs that really do make a difference. And it's phenomenal. And where does it come from? Research. And people like Rotary that are funding that research, just deserve the best accolades, in my opinion.